What's going on, people? So welcome to full day of eating. This is my rest day, but my rest day and training days are actually exactly the same right now, which makes things very easy. My macros are as follows. So protein, 266, carbs, 410, and fat, 73. Okay, that works out about 3,400 calories. I've got two shakes, smoothies. Okay, one is first thing in the morning, post-fasted cardio, one is post-workout. That's how I like to set my day up at the moment. And then I've got three chicken meals. Okay, so at the moment, my hunger isn't too intense. I'm very much looking forward to food before I get to it, which is, you know, such a nice feeling. And every meal is, you know, very enjoyable for me at the moment. I'm absolutely loving eating. But in the first thing in the morning, I like to just, you know, finish my cardio, have a smoothie, get straight to work. I don't want to be preparing food for ages. It just slows me down. And just it being blended just speeds up the digestion and I'm not sat there sluggish. And then the rest are two chicken and rice and one chicken wrap to finish, okay? So for me, how I like to structure my food is meal plan, strict meal plan that I stick to every single day. For me, this works absolutely perfectly. I love the routine. I find peace in the routine. There are other ways to go about it. You could have macros given to me, such as, you know, my coach gives me macros. Every day I choose to eat different food, hitting those macros. Okay, some people like that if it fits your macro approach. I personally do not. I don't like sitting on my fitness pal every day and working shit out. I just want to eat the same thing every day. When you're at a competition level or even a photo shoot, or even if you just want to get, you know, real lean for a holiday, it all comes down to routine and embracing the repetitive nature of this. Every part of my day I really look forward to, and I've structured it so that I almost every single step of my day I massively look forward to and I enjoy. So find a meal plan that you actually enjoy within your macros and calories. Okay, set it up as a structure that you look forward to meals. Now, obviously you can't always just have whatever you want, whenever you want. It's just, life is not that way. You can't expect to keep all your old habits, eating junk food, going out on the piss every weekend, and achieve an amazing physique and get lean and shredded and muscular. You know, you gotta choose, okay? You can't, you know, keep your old ways and expect to achieve new goals. You need to give one up to achieve the other. But that doesn't mean to say that you can't still have an enjoyable meal plan. So I'm gonna go do cardio, okay? And then I'll come back and we'll have our first meal. 100 grams of oats, okay? As you can see here. Then I have 35 grams of whey protein isolate. Then grams frozen fruit, frozen berries, and then 15 grams of dark chocolate. I use isolate because it digests really well, especially whilst I'm on prep. I have no bloating, no gas when I use the whey protein isolate. Obviously it's a bit more expensive, so if you're on a budget, you know, just stick to your normal whey. But seeing as right now, you know, I'm on competition prep, I want everything to be as optimal and as on point as possible, I'll spend the extra 10 quid or whatever it is to get the isolate. So a little bit of salt. That was quite a lot, actually. And then 15 of dark choc, 85%. Okay. Gosh. So water on top. As you can see, so quick and easy to prep. If you're someone who is, you know, working in the morning, you need to get out of the house. 600 cows here, bosh. So rest day activity, go out for a walk. So sunny, I'm gonna go out for a walk, get a coffee. Obviously I'm on prep, so you can't go out and get a lovely oat latte, nice and creamy. So what the order is a double espresso, iced and blended, okay? So it becomes like a slushy, and it's literally like fuck all cows, because obviously it's just a double espresso, no milk, nothing else. Okay, I'm gonna have a little walk, maybe get a sunbed and then come back.
This is what we call the blowjob alley, as Margot well knows. I'm joking. And many a BJ has occurred by the night walkers down here.
Meal two, chicken and rice, prepared by Margot behind the camera. As you can see, we bulk cook, well, we at the moment, Margot does it. Tips, lads. There's a tier of dating girls when you're bodybuilding. So lowest possible tier is an unsupportive girlfriend, doesn't like you going to the gym, okay, goes out every weekend, stresses you out. This is the worst that you could get involved with if you're dreams and goals are bodybuilding. Middle tier, being single, okay? So just doing your own thing, living that life, because then you can pick and choose when you want to see people, you just want your own company. Top tier is a supportive girlfriend who helps you on your journey, also trains ideally, and does stuff like meal prep for you. 200 grams of cooked chicken breasts, 200 grams of cooked rice, okay? This is prepared. I'm actually gonna show you how we prepare the chicken, how we bulk cook it. Margaret's raising her eyebrows, how she prepares the chicken. But obviously, at some point, I will have to do it myself. So, 200 grams of chicken, 200 grams of rice, and 200 grams of pineapple as well. Nice and easy, round numbers. And, is it 5 or 10 grams of olive oil?
5.
Margaret actually knows my meal plan better than me. She makes it for me. I sound like I don't even know what I sound like. I sound like a fucking king, that's what I sound like. So, first chicken and rice meal of the day. What we try and do is split them up. Well, me and Margaret actually have pretty much the exact same meals at the moment. Just different portions, obviously. And we're also prepping for the same show, so it makes life very easy. What we do is the first chicken and rice meal. This is normally my pre-workout meal as well, but on the rest day, it's just my meal too. So I just have it quite fairly plain. Salt, pepper, obviously seasoning on the chicken. Nando's sauce, little bit of Nando's sauce. This is actually pretty low calorie. Amount per tablespoon is 20 cals. I probably have half a tablespoon. It goes quite a long way. Some jalapenos, should I say. And then what we have is fizzy drink, okay? So I have this on a rest day with lunch. So 2 calories for the can. Aldi, the fake Fantas, these are the absolute one. Better than the real Fanta, in my opinion. And vitamin C with a liter of water. That is my meal. Well then, this is how we prepare our chicken for a few days. So in the oven, as you can see, a little bit of seasoning. Today we went for southern fried seasoning. Film.
Yeah, I'll take the forks so I can hold the camera.
Oh, my bad. What we do is like this. Shred it apart like this. Shred it into little pieces, and then it's like shredded chicken. Mixes with the rice really well. Obviously it takes a fair while to do, but this is how I like it, okay? Like I said, I'll do it shit so that you'll never ask me to do it again. But yeah, and then what we'll do is it ends up in a whole, you know, big tray of shredded up chicken, and then we just pick at it, you know, for our meals, and that'll last us for a few days. And then same with the rice, we'll just bulk cook all the rice as well. And then we've got the rice and chicken in the fridge, and that's done for the next few days. And that's the key to staying on point and consistent and preparing for times when you're busy and stressed, whatever, is just get your food prepared, get it in the fridge. Then the easy option is to eat your meal plan. You don't want the easy option to be ordering a takeaway or getting a meal deal or something like that, the easy option wants to be, oh, my meal's already in the fridge, let's have that.
Here is the rice, sushi rice. Get it from the Chinese supermarket. Yep, so chicken there, rice in the pot, ready to go.
That's fucking busted. That one, I think. You can't beat that. I reckon that and the wife are up there.
That doesn't taste
like
mango.
Makes me want to punch my wife.
Or doesn't.
And it makes me need a piss instantly. Meal three, so this would normally be post-workout. I'd normally have cream of rice if it was post-workout, but on a rest day I'll have oats. So 110 grams of oats, then 40 grams of whey, 50 grams of frozen fruit, like before, just smaller amount of fruit, and then 20 grams of honey. As I get deeper into preparations, I will obviously be making these into meals to give myself more volume and more satisfaction from eating. But I'm at a position right now where, you know, I can't really be bothered to be sat there eating oats because I've got work to do today. So I'd rather just get it in, get it done, get back to work. To be accurate, guys, to the ground. Meal four, ladies and gents. So, once again, 200 grams of cooked chicken breast, 150 grams of sushi rice. Then we're gonna be having 15 grams of almond butter, okay? So, if you're putting almond butter or any type of peanut butter, whatever, into a bowl, you know when you get it onto the spoon, you can't get it off, it's sticking to it. Here's a hack, right? Bit of warm water, or any water. On the spoon, make the spoon wet. Then, when you put it onto the spoon, let's hope it works, falls off. Look at that, magic, ladies and gents. So the finishing touches are pickled pink onions, okay, and jalapenos. I'm then gonna be using this sauce for this meal. Sour cream topping, it's only 13 calories. Per serving, I'll probably have less than a serving on that anyways. So yeah, that's the meal four. Absolutely lovely, can't fault it. Last meal, chicken wrap, okay? This is something, I absolutely love wraps. I love Mexican food, nachos, burritos, fajitas, okay? So at the moment, I'm in the part of prep, like I said before, where, you know, I've got plenty of food to work with, so I want something, you know, at the end of the day that I really look forward to. And for me, that's, I've got chicken wrap, so a tortilla wrap, only 100 grams of chicken here, 30 grams of mature cheddar cheese, lovely, bit of guacamole, sour cream, and that's it. And then 200 grams of pineapple as well to finish. So that's my full day of eating wrapped up. All right, so training day, rest day, the exact same right now. So I'm just gonna run through, I just ran through everything. End of day macros. I've just run it all through my fitness pal again at the end of the day. And my protein, 266, fats, 73, and carbs are 410. So that leaves the end day at 3,398. This is very routine, very monotonous. I eat this the exact same every single day. That's why it's so important, and I say to everyone, find enjoyment in the food that you make. I genuinely very much look forward to every one of those meals. you know, on the lead up to it, I'm super, super up for it. And there's not one meal on that plan there that I don't enjoy. At the end of the day, we are, if you're doing a competition, it's gonna be a lot more hardcore dieting. You have to take it to that extra level. But if you hate your food from literally day one, from 16 weeks out, it's gonna be a very miserable process. And for me, I'm absolutely loving it. Every day is an absolute blessing. I'm very grateful to be doing what I'm doing, and that's why it's going so well. I love it. I love the grind. I love the hustle. I love it when it gets hard, and I love the routine and the monotony. Very, very excited to see what happens over the coming weeks. Next week, the food will stay the same. I've actually just had a check-in with Ross there. No changes for next week. Everything's going great. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. My weight's coming down nicely. I've lost 2 kilograms this week, so on we go.